Is there such a thing as over masturbation or masturbating too much? I was part of an article with other colleagues giving my expert opinion on masturbation and health risks, and if a person masturbates too often, will it cause a problem? I've also been asked this by viewers: how many times a week does a person masturbate? If they're masturbating a couple times a day, is it too much? A couple times a week, is it too much? Basically, what's the average amount of time that people spend masturbating? And what are some of the myths or risks involved in masturbation? And what are some of the positive effects of masturbation? First of all, I want to read you from the National Survey of Sexual Health and Behavior. This is the percentage of Americans performing certain sexual behaviors, and this would be on masturbating alone. And I thought this was an interesting survey. So, in the age group of 20 to 24, men masturbated 83% of the time and women 64% of the time. So, this is kind of a comparison of the difference between masturbation patterns of men versus women. In the age group of 25 to 29, men masturbated 84% of the time and women 72% of the time. In the age group of 30 to 39, men masturbated 80% of the time and women 63% of the time. In the age group of 40 to 49, men masturbated 76% of the time and women 65% of the time. And in the age group 50 to 59, men masturbated 72% of the time and 54% of the time. In the age group 60 to 69, men masturbated 61% of the time and women 47% of the time. So, it's interesting to see that they were able to get some type of statistics on this because many times people don't really talk about how often they masturbate, especially women. They don't talk about it as much as men do. So let me go over some of the myths surrounding masturbation and some of the facts. So first of all, we have myth number one, and this is one of the most common myths related to masturbation shaming is the idea that once you're partnered, they gain ownership of your sex and your genitals. So basically, what this means is if you're in a relationship and you're masturbating in between sex or you're masturbating in a relationship, there's nothing wrong with it. It's very normal to continue to masturbate when you're in a relationship, and in fact, it can be healthy. The only time it becomes unhealthy is when it takes away from the relationship itself. And that's the one thing I pointed out here. Truth, masturbation can become a problem if you are substituting it for sex with your significant other. Another myth is masturbation is unhealthy and can lead to health problems. Masturbation is not unhealthy, and in fact, a truth, masturbation can relieve stress. Truth, masturbation can help balance your hormones. Truth, regular masturbation can help increase sexual desire. And this is something that is not often talked about. So, if you have a masturbation pattern where you're masturbating every day before you got into a relationship, and then once you get into a relationship, you're having the honeymoon phase where you're having quite a bit of sex. Maybe the sex slows down, so you go back to masturbating in between. So, therefore, your regular routine is having an orgasm every day, or maybe it was every other day. It really depends on the person and what your routine is. But normally, you're going to go back to what your routine was before you got into a relationship. Unfortunately, for some women who don't get into a masturbation routine, once the sex is not happening as often, they're not masturbating as often in a relationship. And this can lead to loss of desire. And in fact, in this survey, which I find very, very interesting, it talks about masturbate with a partner when you're in a relationship. And in the age group of 30 to 39, 75% of men are still masturbating while in a relationship, as opposed to 5% of women. The age of 40 to 49, 62% of men are still masturbating while in the relationship, and only 2% of women are masturbating. Age 50 to 59, 49% of men are still masturbating and only 1% in women. And the same goes for 60 to 69, 38% in men and 1% in women. So the reality is that women don't masturbate once in a relationship, whereas men do. And so if they're not masturbating, they're not continuing this kind of sexual routine, and the body is not used to having an orgasm or a release. So masturbation is very important. It's very important when you're not in a relationship, as well as very important when you're in a relationship. The only time that it becomes a problem is once in a while when it's associated with obsessive compulsive disorder or some type of an anxiety disorder, and you're using masturbation as the outlet. That can be a problem. One other issue is if you find that you're using masturbation instead of going out and meeting people, you're using it in place of going to work, you're using it in place of doing other activities, then you need to cut down on masturbating. So that's basically the information on masturbation. And if you have any comments, please leave your comments so we can talk about this. Give me a thumbs up if you like the video, and of course, subscribe. I believe everyone deserves to have a healthy sex life, and so do you.